Dear friends, welcome back! I am Nick from educates.tv and today we are going to see how to use the 4.3-inch e-paper display with Arduino. The big advantage of this display is its power consumption. It can display text and graphics even if it is not connected to power. Without any further delay, let's get started! Electronic paper and e-paper are display technologies that mimic the appearance of ordinary ink on paper. Unlike conventional backlit flat panel displays that emit light, electronic paper displays reflect light, like paper. This makes them more comfortable to read and provide a wider viewing angle than most light-emitting displays. Many electronic paper technologies hold static text and images indefinitely without electricity. That's why I wanted to test an e-paper display with Arduino. I would like to find out if it can benefit our Arduino projects, so I chose to test the 4.3-inch e-paper display that I found on gearbest.com. The display costs around $61 and gearbest.com webstore was kind enough to send me a sample unit in order to test it and share my opinion about it with you. You can find a link for the display in the description of the video. As you can see, the display is big. Its resolution is 800 by 480 pixels. It can display graphics and text, and it can display 4 shades of gray. We only need to connect 5 wires in order to make it work with Arduino. VCC goes to Arduino 5 volts. Ground goes to Arduino ground. D-out pin goes to RX pin of the Arduino Uno. D-in pin goes to TX pin of the Arduino Uno. Lastly, wake up pin goes to digital pin 2. The software side of the project is very easy as well. All we need to do is to use the library that comes with the display and load the demo sketch. That's it! The library provides all the basic functions in order to display text and graphics on the display easily. Let's watch for a few seconds the demo sketch. As you can see, the display is able to display graphics, it can draw shapes, and it has a couple of fonts installed, English and Chinese. The refresh rate of the display is low, it can take up to 3 seconds to update, so we have to forget playing animations on it. The big advantage of the display is its power consumption. Check this out. If I remove power from the display, the text does not disappear. We don't need power to display something on the display. We only need power in order to update it. Great! But how much current do we need in order to update it? Let's find out! At the back of the display, we can find something interesting. We can find a big ARM processor that runs at 72 MHz. There is also 128 MB of flash memory for image storage and an SD card slot. It is like having an Arduino Duo to control the display. That's not promising at all about the power consumption. Using a multimeter, we can see that the display needs around 110 milliamps of current when it is updating and about 4 milliamps when it is sleeping. The sleeping current is not bad for a big display like this, but too big for battery-powered projects. So, in order to use this display in a battery-powered project, we have to disable it every time it is updated using a transistor. This way, we can reduce the current down to zero for the display. Since the update current is huge for an embedded project, this display is ideal for battery-powered projects that update the display rarely, let's say once a day. I am looking forward in building a project with this display in order to see how long we can make it last on batteries. That's my first experience with any paper display and I think that the e-paper technology is a very promising one. I would like to hear your thoughts on that. What do you think about this display? Can it be useful to your projects? Do you have any projects in mind that will benefit from a display like this? Please post any comments or ideas in the comments section below. Also, if you want to see the latest channel news, like what project I am currently working on, you can follow the Facebook page of the channel at facebook.com/educatestv. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I build projects with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, I build robots and simple electronic circuits. I love making things and helping people doing the same. I hope that you will join our community. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build!